Welcome at WBP Stars. My name is Thomas Locus. I'm the head chef from Brasserie Julie in Sint-Martens-Bodegem, just next to Brussels. Today we're here at our demonstration kitchen from Miele in our bed and breakfast. And I'm going to prepare for you today one of our classic dishes, osobuco in a classic style, but where the main ingredient is the most important to me. So for this osobuco, I've chosen veal from Corrèze. You see, it's has a nice pink color. So we're going to start by making some slices in the meat. That is to make sure it doesn't start to crawl when we bake it. I'm going to season it. And then we just rolled into some flour to make it nice crispy. So. Now we heat some oil in the pan. We don't use butter because we don't want it, the meat to get black. It's just gonna be nice crispy in the oil. Now it's nice colored on one side. I'm going to turn it. Now we're going to start to add the vegetables, some onions. Carrots. The celery. Garlic. And a bit of rosemary and thyme. We're going to season very gently, because the meat was already seasoned. Now the vegetables have already some color. I'm going to deglaze the pan with white wine. And when it's completely reduced, we're going to add some passata, some tomato. Some veal stock. finally also some chicken stock. Everything together. Baking powder, paper on it. Close it with a lid. And we put it in the oven for 2 hours on 150 degrees. So now we're going to make the gremolata. Why do I use the gremolata is to give some freshness to the ossobuco. So I'm going to start with the person. Chop it really, really fine. Now, we'll take some garlic. Some zest of citron. It's gonna be really fresh on the tender meat. Some melted sea salt. And some good olive oil. This is ready. It's also nice to use on some salads in summer. Or on a good piece of beef, also really nice. It is already on the sides. Now for the garnish for the ossobuco, I've chosen for some Belle de Fontenay potatoes, some cherry tomatoes, some shimiji mushrooms, and we're going to add some basil to that at the end to give a good freshness. So I'm going to start by cutting the potatoes. We're just going to boil them in some water. Gonna add some salt. In the meantime, I'm also going to heat some olive oil in the pan. Take away the cherry tomatoes, the mushrooms, I'm just gonna cut the ends of the mushrooms. So now I'm gonna bake the potatoes in some olive oil. Gonna season a bit. I'm gonna add some tomatoes. And some mushrooms. Finish it with some fresh basil. Now after 2 hours, we're gonna take out the osobuco from the oven. Just gonna take out the meat of the pan and then finish the sauce. garnish our sauce with a small piece of cold butter to make it nice and shiny. Now we're going to do the plating of the ossobuco. Put it in the middle of a deep plate. Put some sauce on top. Add some tomatoes. The mushrooms. The remoulade. I'm gonna top it with some Parmesan cheese. So this is our ossobuco, and hope to see you soon in Belgium.